Thanks. We have time for a few questions, and because this is being recorded in the entirety, I will briefly summarize them. Yes. Yes, two questions. One about how the exposedfacts.org website will function, and the other about Secretary of State Kerry's recent comments regarding Edward Snowden and his call to, quote, man up, unquote. I'm sure some of the panelists may have some comments, certainly on the second one. Perhaps never was the direct correlation between patriarchy and militarism more well expressed. I haven't heard too many calls for people to woman up. I'm not sure exactly what that would entail. But the fatuous and absurd illogic of claims from Secretary of State Kerry and other administration officials have been repeated very frequently about Edward Snowden. And I think I'll leave it to some other panelists on that, except to say that when you take someone's passport away and you force down the airplane of a head of state of a Latin American country and you make clear that you will do everything in your power to essentially abduct and put somebody in solitary, as was done to Chelsea Manning, and then you turn around and claim that they should just come on back to an, in effect, injustice system, well, we're just down the rabbit hole, which is, seems to be where Secretary Kerry wants us to go. Briefly about the Exposed Facts website. It's been in preparation for about 10 months. And Exposed Facts is very appreciative to the Freedom of the Press Foundation, the nonprofit organization, which has done a lot of in-kind contributing to our group to provide software, installation, training, and ongoing consultation, so that if now someone goes to the website and has a Tor browser and wishes to submit documents to Exposed Facts, they can do so. And while we are very clear that no one can or should credibly promise confidentiality, because there's human error on the planet and there's certainly NSA efforts to breach confidentiality between sources and journalists, this organization, Exposed Facts, is doing everything it can, from journalistic commitment and through our technological access to the Secure Drop software, to provide confidentiality for every source who desires it. And as an editorial board, we will sift through all the submissions, the wheat from the chaff, and do due diligence. There's one other aspect I want to mention. Since 1998, the Institute for Public Accuracy has developed what in sports would be called a deep bench. We have literally several thousand experts who we have consulted with and who have been on our news releases on a very wide range of policy. And that is a group of several thousand who, if appropriate, we can check with and get guidance and expertise from about material that may be submitted. Are there other comments about Secretary Kerry's would-be illumination on the subject of Edward Snowden?
I would just stand up.
Yeah. I would respond by simply saying it's a tremendous display of abject ignorance for a senior official in the government to assert that there is some viable path that Ed Snowden has. Tom Drake, Bill Binney, myself, and others are prima facie evidence of the fact that channels don't work because there are none. And now we're finding out the inspectors general at a number of organizations are what? Corrupt. So where do you go? To John Kerry? I don't think so. The point being, we really aren't having an effective discussion when Mr. Kerry stands up and makes such statements. And it just goes to show how far we need to go before grown people sit down and actually solve the problem.
I'd like to add something to this, and specifically saying that we're getting all these kinds of statements from our government officials who are doing everything they can to keep everything they're doing secret from you. And so they're consistently lying to you about everything. For example, when they go into court and say, we don't do this under this program, or they say that in testimony to the judiciary committees in the Senate or the House, that's a key term for it's being done under another program. Okay, that's what that means, and so they're manipulating the words. They're lying indirectly to you because they don't want to tell you the truth. They can't even own up to what they're doing, so they're keeping all of this secret from you and lying over and over again. And they won't stand up and be accountable for what they're doing, and yet they want to have Snowden come back and be accountable for him and man up. I say they need to man up.
This government is so efficient at making examples of whistleblowers that I think it would be almost impossible for any of us not to know that there are consequences for telling the truth if you work for the federal government. This is an administration that has used the Sabotage Act more than any other administration in the history of this country. And I think we all know what will happen to Mr. Snowden when he comes back. I mean, we really do know. We've had enough examples to really understand that he will be railroaded. He will be tried in the kangaroo court very much like Chelsea Manning, and he will be imprisoned for the rest of his life. And if he is by some, you know, extraordinary circumstance found innocent, then I would dare say that there's probably a car accident with his name on it. So I think that it's important for us to be realistic about the government that's in power right now and not to be naive, because too much is at stake for us to maintain this very Pollyannish idealism about what this government is really about. For those of us who have been on the inside and have seen it, it is a chilling, it is extremely frightening. I so hope, and I'm so proud of you, and I'm so proud of your work. And I'm hoping so much that Mr. Snowden finds a place where he can be safe on this planet without having to come back to the United States and face the wrath of the state here.
A couple quick, very quick comments. First, to the press, I want to recommend, if you want to pursue this topic further, we're going to be breaking up in a few minutes. You could stay in the room and do one-on-one interviews with the three people you've just heard from. Mm-hmm. And also, there are no people on the planet more expert and discerning and clear about this topic than two members of the advisory board of Exposed Facts who are here today in the front row, Justin Raddick from the Government Accountability Project and Thomas Drake. And hopefully they will be here after the news conference for interviews as well if you have any questions. As it turns out, exposedfacts.org has a direct response to Secretary of State Kerry's comments less than a block from his office at the State Department. And I want to call your attention to Dan Ellsberg's words that are on that transit shelter billboard half a block from the State Department building, where Daniel Ellsberg says that he is urging, quote, and this is in very big letters next to the State Department, people to, quote, tell the truth with documents that reveal lies or crimes or internal projections of costs and dangers. Don't wait until a new war has started. Don't wait until thousands more have died. You might save a war's worth of lives, unquote. And that is another response to Secretary Kerry. Other questions? The exact address, thanks for that question. The bus shelter billboard is on 23rd Street Northwest, and it's is it between Constitution?
Just north of Constitution, just south of the State Department.
South of the State Department, next to Constitution Avenue as well.
Yeah.
And it will be up for the entire month, yes. Will we accept classified documents? The answer is absolutely yes. We are a journalistic organization. The Institute for Public Accuracy has been here in the National Press Building since 1998. We have many, many journalists who are integral to this project. And speaking personally for a moment, as executive director of the Institute for Public Accuracy, I've been a journalist for more than 40 years. Yes?
What will be the process once you receive a submission? Will you talk with news organizations? Will you consult with them? Or will you just publish stuff on exposed facts?
What will be the process of exposed facts after we get information submitted? Well, we will triage the information. We'll sift it out. We will vet it in terms of authenticity. And public interest value, and we'll proceed as independent journalists should, which is to assess how to best get the information out in journalistic form to the public. And in some cases, we will publish it initially in journalistic form at exposedfacts.org. In other cases, we will not do that. We will build liaisons with independent journalists or other news organizations for publishing that material.
Have you consulted with them?
Have we consulted with other news organizations? Yes, we've been in dialogue already with several news organizations, some of whom have gone out of their way to ask us to consider approaching them about particular information. We have been asked as well, will we contact the government? Vis-a-vis documents that come in that may be governmental in nature. And again, we would behave as, at their best, some mainline large U.S. media institutions do behave. We will not behave like the New York Times under Bill Keller when that organization cravenly went to the White House in 2004 when they had documentation of massive NSA wiretapping, and then held the information for more than a year, well into 2005 before publication, and then with the explanation in effect, and I'm paraphrasing here, that the Times did not want to seem to have a partisan agenda, which would translate as the Times wanted to not have their journalism have political impact, which is a strange precept for a journalistic institution to pursue.
Could I add one thing on papers being submitted that are classified? Not too many people are paying too much attention to this, but under Executive Order 13526, Section 1.7, this is the executive order that governs classification for the U.S. government. You cannot use classification to cover up a crime, illegality, abuse of any form, or abuse, or fraud, corruption, waste, or embarrassment, and a number of other things. That's all in Section 1.7 of Executive Order 13526. And a lot of these things that Snowden exposed were, in fact, evidence of crimes against the Constitution or other laws that existed as statutes in the country here. So those things cannot legitimately be classified under that executive order.
Briefly, I want to mention the insider threat program, which was exposed by McClatchy News Service. In a very real sense, among other functions, exposedfacts.org intends to be an antidote to the poison of the insider threat program, which is antithetical to a democratic society. Yes?
You mentioned the Tor browser. Do you know to whatever, if any, extent it has been compromised by NSA?
I'll defer to those with much greater expertise than I, Bill or.
Well, I know they're working on it. I think it's it causes a lot of work for them, so it's a manual effort. So it's not like a computer algorithm going through. So this is difficult for them. That's why I advocate using codes instead of ciphers, because you can use a computer algorithm to go to cipher. You can't a code. So that makes humans have to get involved. So that makes a lot of work for them. So, and I think Tor does the same thing. I'm not sure how. I've not been there for 12 years, so I don't know effectively what they're doing there for sure. Perhaps there's some material in Snowden's that's been unpublished from Snowden that might expose some of that.
Are there any other questions? Okay.
Sorry,
yes.
You mentioned you have been in contact with these organizations. Can you say which ones?
No, we're in consultation professionally, but they include individual journalists and one of the leading political magazines in the country. Any other questions? Okay, well, with that, then I hope you'll do some one-on-one interviews, and thank you very much for being here.